everybody. Welcome to Lessons on 48th Lane. We're so glad that you could join us. Remember, it's all about slime. And we have a really fun lesson tonight. And we're so excited that you are here joining us. And a big shout out to the school kids that hopefully will be watching this either Friday or next week. And we're glad that you guys can be here as well. We have so much fun sharing the story of Jacob with all of you and our slime.
What grade are we shouting out to this week?
I don't know. Which grade?
Last week it was fourth grade, wasn't it?
It was.
Should we do first grade?
I wonder. We could do a
shout out to the first graders, to St. John. Hey, first graders. Pastor Jeff.
Miss Annette,
we're
so glad that you could be here and watch us later on this week.
So you're saying hi, I need to get
I'm
this.
I'm saying hi, and we're getting ready for our song.
Our theme song.
Yes.
I wonder if any of the kids have actually learned it yet.
I don't know. We should ask them.
We should ask them.
We'll just have to pop in sometime and ask them.
It's Thursday night.
Story is about actually two brothers. They were twins, Jacob and hopefully you'll be able to say and
in their classroom. I wonder if they're yelling it out.
I bet they are. And Esau. And remember, they had a mom and dad named Rebecca and Isaac. And if you can remember, Rebecca loved which brother more? If you said Jacob, you're right. And Isaac loved Esau more. And remember that Esau was the hunter. And you gotta remember that Esau came home one day and he was starving and he sold his birthright for a bowl of soup. That's right. And then later on, we find out how Jacob really was very slimy and was able to trick Isaac out of Esau's blessing. And when he did that, Esau was going to kill him. And so he had to run away. And remember when we did that glow-in-the-dark lesson about there was, can you remember what was in our kitchen? I think it was something that had steps on it. It was a ladder. And we had angels ascending and descending, right? And the voice of God promised Jacob that he would be with him no matter what. And so then Jacob met a lovely young woman named Rachel, and also met Rachel's dad, whose name was, what was his name? Started with an L. I think it was Laban. And Jacob fell in love with Rachel, but Rachel had an older sister named, another L word, Leah.
Leah!
That's right, Leah. And so Jacob really wanted to marry Rachel. So Laban said, you need to work for me for 7 years and then you can have Rachel. Well, on the wedding day when it came, Laban was the one who was slimy, right? And Jacob ended up marrying Leah. And then he had to work for some more time for Laban and he finally got to marry Rachel. And then last week we talked all about the sheep. And remember how Laban said you can have these sheep, right? Do you remember that? And then he was slimy again to Jacob. But God blessed Jacob. So I think that's where we're at with our story. And we're going to do a little skit to introduce the story about Jacob this week. So I don't know, but I hear that we have a special guest appearance here on the WWCC, which is the World Wrestling Classic Channel. I wonder who's dropping by. Oh, wait, here he
who,
comes.
Who? I'm here. All right, it's me. Here I am. Let's get this party started.
Pardon me. I'm sort of embarrassed here, but I am not sure who you are.
How can this be? You're not recognizing the greatest wrestler ever to wrestle on this planet?
Who are you again? It is. I just don't know who you are.
How do you not recognize Jake, the Jacobnator? The Jacobnator's here.
The Whoinator?
The Jacobnator.
Well, you look pretty old. Yeah. So you'll have to help me out here.
Look, I've been watching the wrestling of this day, and it's all right, it's entertaining, but I mean, like, it only lasts like 6 or 7 minutes, and somebody ends up going down, and somebody gets the crown.
Well, I guess that's true, yeah.
And I mean, there was that guy, like that Cassius Ohno guy.
Oh, yeah, we did a whole feature story on him.
Well,
yeah.
According to you guys, he holds the world's record for wrestling in a wrestling match over 3 hours.
Yes, he does hold that world record.
Well, I say no, he does not. He supposedly holds the record, but that's why I'm here. You guys got it all backwards.
Let's see, maybe you better talk to me about what you mean here.
Gladly. Let me tell you my story here. I was a young man at one time, and I was always kind of a wrestling with the truth, you know. I kind of like to kind of wrestle around with it, and so I'm over there, and I got this Laban guy, and it finally says, you know, I had to leave town because my brother, he and I had a disagreement.
You mean Esau?
Yeah,
Esau.
He had his way of thinking, and I had my way of thinking.
Interesting.
Yeah.
I thought you did something to Esau.
Well, now that's not part of the story tonight.
Okay. Okay.
So I go over, and I'm working for Laban, and I get all these sheep and these goats, and I'm ready. And then the Lord, the Lord, told me, I want you to go back. I want you to go back, and I'm going to patch things up with you and your brother, and I'm going to bless you, and I'm going to be with you.
Were you scared?
Well, at first I thought, well, the Lord's saying, but then the more I started coming back, the more a little scared I got.
Yeah,
and
Esau said he was going to kill you.
Well, yeah, well, there is that.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, you know, people say things, they get angry and stuff. So we're getting closer and closer, and I finally come up with a plan. You know, I'm going to help the Lord out.
Ooh,
I like to help the Lord out.
That's so nice of you.
Yeah, I decided I'm going to divide up all my family and all my goods, and I'm going to send them a couple different ways so that if things go kind of bad with Esau, I'll still be all right.
Mm-hmm.
All right? And then, so I sent them off, and suddenly there was a man.
A man.
Not Esau. No, big man. Powerful man.
Wow.
And that's when I let my inner Jacobnator come out. Mm-hmm. And we wrestled. Not for no 6 or 7 minutes either.
No?
Not even for three hours.
Oh, okay.
We wrestled all night. And it finally was just about to be the daytime. And he said, I gotta go. And I said, I'm not letting you go. And then you know what he did?
What?
He reached out his hand and touched my hip, and it like went out of joint.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah, I couldn't even walk straight, but I would not let go.
You wouldn't?
I wouldn't let go. I said, you can't go until you bless me. And I'm limping around and I'm holding on to him, and I got him in a hold. And he says, what's your name? And I said, I'm the Jacobnator. And he says, your name's going to be Israel.
Wow.
He who wrestles with God.
Wow.
He who wrestles with God. What an awesome name. What an awesome name. And so he says that. And I said, well, what's your name? And you know what he said?
What did he say?
He said, why do you want to know?
Yeah.
And he said, I'm just going to tell you. I'm going to go. And that's when I realized this was no man. Not even a big man. Not even a strong man.
Who was it then?
It was an angel of the Lord.
Wow.
It was an angel of the Lord. And so I called that place Peniel.
Mm-hmm.
It means I have seen God's face and lived.
Wow.
Wow. So I'm just telling you, man, at that point, that's when I hung up my robe and I said, the Jacobnator is no more.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just going to go by my new name, Israel.
Wow. And you wrestled all night long?
All night long.
And you said you wrestled with an angel of the Lord?
God is my witness.
Wow. So, folks, that is quite the story.
And cut.
All right. That was a really cool story from the Bible about Jacob.
Genesis chapter 32.
And you know what you can do? If you want, you can open up your Bibles when we're done tonight, or maybe tomorrow, or whenever you watch it, and you can go ahead and read that story from the Bible. Now, we have something pretty cool tonight. It's a different kind of slime. And it is actually made with cornstarch and water. And I think it's so
cool. Mrs. Shanks, who was that guy? Who was that guy? There was a big guy that just went by.
The Jacobnator.
That's what he said his name was.
I know.
Who let that guy in? It's supposed to be me and you.
And you know what? He said that he wrestled all night long.
All night long?
With the angel of the Lord.
Wow.
That is so cool.
Yeah.
That is so
cool. All right, so what are we showing?
Okay. So anyway, I have this kind of cool slime.
What do you call this kind?
What did I call it? Obling?
Obling?
Something.
Oblet. It's made out. Okay.
I don't know.
This
I can't
is cool.
Remember
and,
now.
And here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to pick this up because you've got to see this stuff. Because
it is really cool.
I will say.
I've been playing with it a lot today.
Mrs. Shanks loves to play. I will tell you this. She drives me a little nuts with the slime stuff. But anyway. It's really cool.
It is so cool.
So here we go.
So anyway.
Wait a minute. We're going to show. All right. So.
There it is.
Wait a minute. Now you got to put it flat. I'll put it in front of it somehow.
All righty. So as you can see, it's kind of hard. So when I scoop it up like this, see how hard it is? And then see how it goes back together again?
And the coolest part is when it goes back together, watch it go back together and then I'm going to touch it.
Yeah. Look at it go. This is so fun. You can make it at home if you want to, too.
Yeah. Mrs. Shanks can get you the recipe.
Yeah, it's really easy.
But then watch this. It's like it's hard.
Yeah, and
it's not liquidy.
It up like this.
And so in order to get it, this is what you got to do.
And I'm going to just do my fork and then watch what happens. Is that not the coolest thing?
Like when it's down there, it's hard.
And then, okay, so we got to do this one more time, and then we'll talk a little bit more about it. So I'm going to watch it go like this, and when it hits down there, it just gets hard again. And this is hard, and it just comes together, and then it just intersects.
Right. So I'm going to put you back here. All right.
And so anyway, we were just thinking about this slime that we have today, and we were thinking about, you know, something about Jacob and his heart. You know, he was wrestling. He believed in God, and he sort of trusted him, but not completely, right?
No, he had a problem.
He had a little bit of doubt.
It always seems like his heart always wanted to go back to be hard,
yeah.
And then he wouldn't trust. And you know what? It's really easy for you and I to say, wow, he's kind of a mess.
Right.
But I got to be honest. There's times when my heart gets kind of hard and I don't know that I trust God's word and he has to soften up my heart.
Yeah, and so that's what this slime reminds us of, is our hearts when they're hard, and then God takes those hearts and he softens them up, right? So that we can begin to trust him again. Because sometimes we're like Jacob. We want to take matters into our own hands.
Yeah.
And we want to fix things.
Just think about Jacob, you know, He helps tell the story of one named Jesus who was going to come. And when Jesus came, he had to deal with a lot of hard hearts,
mm-hmm.
right?
Yeah.
All the people, and even his own disciples sometimes didn't trust. They didn't believe. Their hearts got all hard, and he would have to soften them up. And that's just the way Jesus was. He would just come. And he wrestled with the devil.
Oh, yeah.
He wrestled. Not just for it all night long. For three nights, all right? Three days, and then he came out, what? On Easter Sunday, victorious! There we go.
I was also thinking about that one Bible story we did a while ago about Zacchaeus and his heart.
Oh, yeah.
And how Jesus just softened it right up. So cool. Cornstarch and water. If you want the recipe and want to do this, because I'm going to tell you, I've been playing with it for a long time.
I will say this. She has made a mess.
I have made a mess. That's right.
She goes, can you build me a lab?
She
wants a lab. You know, some women want a she shed. Annette wants a she lab. All right. Yeah. All right. So anyway, it'd be your slime festival, wouldn't it?
Okay. Right.
All right. So are you going to help with the motions?
I'm going to try. Okay.
All right. Now you're not going to have all the words here. It's going to be, but you're going to catch on.
Are you going to do the chorus?
Let's do the chorus
okay.
first.
So we're going to go.
Oh no, you never let go. Through the cold and through the storm. Oh no, you never let go. In every high and every low. Oh no, you never let go. Lord, you never let go of me. Let's try that chorus one more time. Wait a minute. I picked that song because you never let go. Just like, Jacob kept going, I'm not going to let go of you. But here's the thing. God never lets go of us.
No.
And that's what I love about this song. So let's sing it again.
Oh, no, never let go through the calm and through the storm.
Jacob and our slime time, right?
Yes, and we're going to have a special game. We're going to have a special game with some prizes even as we review the story. So think about all the stories because you're going to get a chance, all right?
Yeah, you might want to review in your Bible with your parents. That would be so good.
The whole Jacob stories.
Yeah. And I got two different kinds of slime I'm thinking about.
So yeah, so we don't know which. Which in my mind means she's going to make them both and we're going to have five slime games all week.
Okay. Whatever.
All right.
We just have so much fun at this house.
Yeah.
You got to close in prayer?
Okay.
All right.
Do I have to thank God for slime?
Oh, yeah.
All right.
Of course.
All right. Let's do echo prayer. So you're going to do the echo part, right?
I am going to echo,
You guys echo wherever you're at home. Or in your classroom, all right? So here we go. Dear Jesus.
Dear Jesus.
Thank you for loving us.
Thank you for loving us.
And even when our hearts get hard.
And even when our hearts get hard.
You send your spirit.
You send your spirit.
To soften them up.
To soften them up.
Be with us always.
Be with us always.
Guide us in all where we're going.
Guide us in all where we're going.
So that we know.
So that we know.
We are with you.
We are with you.
Every step of the way.
Every step of the way.
Amen.
Amen.
All right. So that is tonight's. we've got to say it together. One, two, three. Lessons from 48th Lane. All right. We'll be back next week.
Good night, everybody.
All right. Good night.
See you later.
Jacobnator says good night.
Uh-oh.